No professional sports team wants to go so many years without winning a championship. And they especially don't want to go so many years without making the playoffs. But a number of sports teams made some really bad trades, draft choices, and free agent signings that put them in bad positions for the long run. I'm Daquan Young, and today we present 10 sports teams that won't win a championship over the next 10 years. And a big shout out to Connor Bateman for suggesting this video. Number 10, the Los Angeles Kings. It feels weird putting the Kings on here, considering they won the Stanley Cup in 2012 and 14. But all Kings have to be dethroned, and Los Angeles will learn that. They missed the playoffs in 2015 and 17, and were ousted early in the opening round of the 2016 postseason. This team has no upcoming prospects in the farm system, and with such heavy contracts for fading stars like Marian Gaborik and Anze Kopitar, the Kings won't have the cap space to add new stars either. Throw in the fact their Pacific Division rivals are loaded with rising young stars, and the Kings will be way behind in building another championship contender. Number 9, the New Orleans Saints. It doesn't matter if the Saints have a world-class quarterback in Drew Brees. He turned 38 years of age earlier in 2017 and won't be playing in the NFL much longer. If the Saints somehow find a way to fix their defense, that's among the league's worst every year, they'll still need a quarterback replacement for the legendary Brees. Offense is a strength now, but defense is a weakness. And when Brees retires, the offense will be a weakness too. That'll put New Orleans in a bind, regardless of how their defense is by then. Number 8, the Chicago Bulls. So the Bulls barely squeaked into the playoffs in 2017. And they traded off one of the league's most dominant players in Jimmy Butler. This is the start of the rebuild. Dwayne Wade turned out fine in his hometown, but he's in his mid-30s now, and he's not going to play much longer. You know LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers will dominate for a few more years. The Boston Celtics championship window is just opening, and the Toronto Raptors won't be going away anytime soon. It could be a long time until the Bulls find a way to restore the glory years that Michael Jordan brought 2 decades ago. Number 7, the Kansas City Royals. It's odd putting a team on here that won the World Series in 2015, but the Royals don't have the resources to spend money while ensuring their star players remain in KC for the long run. Here's a list of their top players that'll be free agents in the winter of 2017. Eric Hosmer, Lorenzo Cain, Jason Vargas, Mike Moustakas, and Alcides Escobar. The Royals rebuild that formed the 2015 championship team took over a decade. Rebuilds last a long time in baseball, so the Royals better brace themselves for another long decade of misery and frustration. Number 6, the Detroit Red Wings. From 1991 to 2016, the Red Wings made the playoffs every year, took home 6 President's Trophies, and of course, 4 Stanley Cup championships. But general manager Ken Holland has seen an aging roster over the years. Instead of committing to an inevitable rebuild, he handed out long-term contracts to mediocre or average players like Franz Nielsen and Darren Helm. Given how Detroit went over 20 years without a top 10 draft pick, the Wings are way behind in developing future faces of the franchise. Holland said he won't do a full rebuild, which means Detroit is going to remain mediocre at best. Their 25-year dominant run was nice, but it's now back to more pain and misery in Motown. Number 5, the Los Angeles Clippers. All these 50-win seasons are nice for the Clippers, but for one, they're never good enough to get through the Western Conference powerhouses like Golden State or San Antonio. Even though Blake Griffin just resigned, they lost out on superstar Chris Paul, who went to Houston. Now, the Clippers will have a hell of a time finding 2 new stars to build around. This team lost its best chance to win a title, and long-term mediocrity is on the way. Number 4, the New York Jets. The New England Patriots won't stop being the bullies of the AFC East until Tom Brady and Bill Belichick are both retired. That could be another 10 years from now. Brady's talking about playing to his 45. Even if those 2 icons retire today, how would the Jets go about winning? They're not consistently bad enough to load up on top 10 draft picks over long stretches, and they're just never good enough. The Jets' championship drought is almost 50 years. Why can't it be 60? Number 3, the Atlanta Hawks. This offseason, the Hawks lost both Paul Millsap and Dwight Howard. Atlanta's never been able to get past LeBron James. They're a few steps behind teams like Toronto, Washington, and Boston, but since they keep vying for playoff spots, the Hawks can't load up on the necessary top 5 or 10 picks to get a proper rebuild going. They've never been a prime landing spot for top free agents either. The title window for this team closed. Now they have to wait another decade plus to win a championship. At least we think so. Number 2, the Tampa Bay Rays. It was remarkable how the Rays stayed competitive in baseball's toughest division, the American League East. They have one of the league's top third basemen in Evan Longoria. They had a Cy Young winning pitcher in David Price. They had this era's best manager in Joe Maddon. They had a mastermind front office boss, Andrew Friedman, but now Price is in Boston, Maddon is in Chicago, and Friedman is with the Dodgers. Tampa can't compete with high-spending rivals like New York or Boston. They don't have the budget to buy top talent. By the time this team is ready to win titles, they may be relocated. Number one, the Cleveland Browns. At this point, it's less about when the Browns will win a championship and more about when a coach will last in Cleveland for more than 2 years. It's about when will Cleveland have the same starting quarterback for a full 2 seasons. It's about when will the Browns win at least 9 games in a season. It's about when the jokes about this team will end. It's about when they'll stop wasting high first round picks. Let's not talk about titles anytime soon when it comes to the Cleveland Browns, please. Which sports team do you think is the furthest away from competing for a championship? Join us in the comments below. If you like this video and learned a thing or two, clicking the like button helps us out a ton and we truly appreciate it. If this is your first time coming around on Total Pro Sports though, subscribing is a great idea because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching and we'll see you guys next time.